डांस को सम लेक्चर्स स्टडी द वर्टिकल फॉर्मेट वर्टिकल फॉर्मेट इज स्टडी द वर्टिकल फॉर्मेट ऑफ बैलेंस शीट इन बैलेंस शीट वी फॉर्म वर्टिकल फॉर्म ऑफ बैलेंस शीट इक्विटी एंड लायबिलिटी देन ओन फंड लोन फंड एंड टोटल एम्प्लॉयड फंड फिक्टिशियस एसेट व्हाट यू नो दैट फॉर्म ऑफ कंप्लीट बैलेंस शीट इन वर्टिकल फॉर्म स्टडी कंप्लीट बैलेंस शीट इन वर्टिकल फॉर्म फ्रॉम टुडे वी स्टडी वर्टिकल इनकम स्टेटमेंट प्रिपरेशन बाय यू कैसा प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं फर्स्टली द फॉर्मेट यू आर स्टडी टुडे द फॉर्म इन दिस लेक्चर वी स्टडी द फॉर्मेट ऑफ वर्टिकल बैलेंस द फॉर्मेट ऑफ वर्टिकल बैलेंस इज आई एम सेंडिंग समडे रिपोर्ट इन योर कॉमन ग्रो देन दिस कॉमन ग्रो आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग द वन मेन कंपोनेंट इन पर्टिकुलर्स अंडर द वर्टिकल इनकम स्टेटमेंट ओके सो द फर्स्ट इन द इनकम स्टेटमेंट means your income depending on income source. The main income source of your business is your operation. The operation is your business. Operation of your business is sales. Operation of business is sales. Then we have that under this sales, two component are there. Gross sales. It means the total sales, but time of sales, some return, some defective goods are returned to your in your stock. And this stock, this return is deducted from your sales is known as less return. The return deducted after the deduction of your return, some amount are generated is net sale. Okay. After this net sale, B, the main component B is cost of goods sold. The cost of goods sold means the cost of expenditure, time of selling or the making of goods for the selling are prepared. एक्सपेंडिचर असे एक्सपेंडिचर जे वस्तू विकणे किंवा विकण्यासाठी बनवणाऱ्या वस्तूला होणाऱ्या खर्चावर जे वस्तू बनणार आहे इट इज लेस ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इंडिकेटेड ही आर द लेस इट मीन्स हेड द आंसर इज नेट सेल सेलच्या मधून जो कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड लेस होणार आहे तुम्हाला जो आन्सर येणार आहे इट्स क्रॉस मार्जिन आणि क्रॉस प्रॉफिट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्डच्या अंडर काय येतो व्हॉट अंडर द पर्टिक्युलर commodity included in cost of goods sold. I am explaining sometime. Okay. Then, and after that, the gross margin A minus B is A is sales, B is less cost of goods sold. Gross margin is here. After this, the preparation of gross margin, some particulars are remaining are deducted from your expenditure, and these deductions are known as your expenses. And these expenses are the number one, operating expenses. Operating expenses. It means time of operation, time of sale, time of purchase, time of production. The sum operations indirectly affected in your business. It means power. It means electricity, offices, and other. And these expenditures deducted from your business in three parts. The first part is office and administration expenses. In this particular part, official expenses, administrative expenses are deducted, which is I'm explaining. In some time, after this office and expenditure deducted, the second part, selling and distribution. The second part is selling and distribution expenses. Under this selling and distribution, some sales, distribution, and selling of distribution, time of sale and distribution expenditure. Right? Under this selling and distribution expenses, time of selling, the number of expenditure are done there, and this number of expenditure are calculated under this. Whatever of that and which one is made particular commodity are explained in some time. Okay, then finance expenses. In the financial expenses, some financial expenses in this particular part, some financial expenses like bank charges, financially time of finance, some expenditure are done by you. These expenses are deducted from posted here. Okay. That operating profit, why is I telling that operating profit? Because your operating expenses are deducted from your gross margin. Okay, for example, A minus B is known as gross margin or gross profit minus C. C is here deducted and less operating expenses. Less is here, that is deducted. Some answer is deducted here, it's called operating profit. Why calling it the operating profit, not net profit? In 12, we are deducted from the profit and loss account to become the net profit, but you have some expenditure remaining in years or incurring remaining in year, of course, head under the sun expenditure, non-operating expenditure. It means this expenditure doing or not doing, but not affecting on your business. Owner, even I owner, but not affecting on your business. It means sale of fixed asset. Asset declared. Sale of asset. Asset, after the selling of asset, the business has stopped there. No. Some part of assets here sale out. Sale of part of machine or scrap and all. Some asset expenditure, the expenditure tailor to your night collection, production, sale are not stopped. Your business working in form, not stopping your business and all is known as non-operating expenses. As compared to the operating expenses, these expenditure are recurring in nature, affected on business indirectly, but is recurring. They honor as that and for that, they honor as that and hota hai ki manual production hota hai, production on sale doing as that. It was non-operating expense. Okay? Then some non-operating income, there is profit in sale of business, directly profit in sale of unproductive assets, then profit on direct investment, interest on investment, dividend receive and etc. Per year, they hota hai, kabhi to hi honor as that. Yeah. After that, this after that, the all of these NPBIDT, NPBIDT, it is net profit before interest, tax, and depreciation amount is here. And says that net profit before interest, tax, and depreciation. It means your depreciation deduction remains as it is. Your depreciation deductions is remains as it is. For example, time of profit and loss account, preparing of profit and loss account to depreciation. Directly we have to do profit and loss debit budget to depreciation. We have to do it direct post. In time of your format, official admission, no depreciation including here. No selling depreciation, no financial expenses, no depreciation. The depreciation could be post for that personal purpose. NPBI to churn and cut means make profit before interest, tax, and depreciation churn and cut. All over depreciation reduction here. Then depreciation they were deducted after the deduction of all over depreciation. The main part this year included it. Then the proper answer some after some deduction depreciation I deducted NPBIT after NPBIT. What is the NPBIT? It means net profit before interest and tax. It means net profit before interest and tax. It means profit is here, but tax payment is remaining. Debenture interest is remaining. As per NPBIDT, profit is remaining. Profit is done, but interest remaining, tax remaining, depreciation remaining. Similar here, profit is here, but interest and tax is remaining. And from that, if your interest are deducted, your answer is NPBT, net profit before tax. It means profit is done here, but tax is remaining. Income tax payment is remaining. Income tax payment is remaining. After that, NPBT, less tax order is here. After that, NPBT, less tax order is here. And after the tax deduction, the answer is NPAT, not net profit after tax. It means your net profit. Okay? Net profit is done here. Me puna ekda puna explain karto. एक-एक गोष्टी मध्ये काय काय खरं घडलेलं आहे ते मी तुम्हाला सांगतो. फर्स्ट युअर ऑपरेशन इट मीन सेल्स मध्ये काय होतं तर आपल्याकडे सेल्स आणि क्रेडिट मध्ये रिटर्न किंवा सेल्स रिटर्न दिलेलं असतं. यू टेकिंग द फर्स्ट ग्रॉस सेल्स. तुम्ही आधी काय घेणार ग्रॉस सेल्स घेणार आणि आउट ऑफ दिस ग्रॉस सेल्स रिटर्नला लेस करणार. रिटर्न मीन्स सेल्स रिटर्न डिडक्ट करणार. इट्स युअर प्रॉपर सेल्स बिकॉज रिटर्न रिटर्न आले तर पैसे रिटर्न द्यायचे. इट मीन्स युअर प्रॉपर सेल्स. Then after this proper sale, the trading account commodity, trading account where the JK is, these are posting under the cost of goods sold. In short, time of production, the cost of goods sold, means the necessity cost of goods, the cost of production cost are posted here. It means the cash, maybe purchase, carriage inward, tariff, opening stock of raw material, closing stock of raw material, JK trading account. Cost of under cost of goods sold. A deduct केल्यानंतर जसं तिथे ट्रेडिंग अकाउंटचा एन्सर ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट यायचा ग्रॉस मार्जिन ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट बन सकता है, देन अपने दस ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट ये देखते हैं ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट क्या कहते हैं, ट्रांसफर टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट क्रेडिट साइड बाय ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट। ओके सिमिलर ईयर फ्रॉम दिस ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट तुम्हें प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस के एक्सपेंडिचर है तो डिडक्ट करना है, इतने ही अपन को एक्सपेंडिचर डिडक्ट करना रहा, बट इन थ्री पार्ट हेड पार्ट इज टू पार्ट ऑपरेटिंग एंड नॉन ऑपरेटिंग। फर्स्ट पार्ट इज ऑपरेटिंग, अंडर दिस ऑपरेटिंग ऑफिस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेंसेस। ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस मध्ये ऑफिस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मध्ये काय ऑपरेशन व्हायचं, फर्स्ट इज प्रिंटिंग एंड स्टेशनरी, देन एलआयसी प्रीमियम एंड ऑल जे काय ऑफिशियल एक्सपेंडिचर व्हायचे जे केलं तर बिझनेस आपला फॉर्म मध्ये आहे, तुला सिक्युरिटी मिळेल, सिक्युरिटी इज फॉर्म लाईक इन्शुरन्स ऑफ युअर गुड्स एंड ऑल दॅट मेन्शन देअर, देन टाइम ऑफ सेलिंग सम एक्सपेंडिचर व्हायचे बॅड डेट्स ट्रॅव्हलिंग चार्जेस मीन्स गुड ट्रान्सपोर्ट प्राइस एक्सपोर्ट फिनिश होईल, देन अदर इज सेलिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्युशन, देन त्याच्यानंतर सम फिनान्शियल एक्सपेंडिचर व्हायचे लाईक चेक बाउंस झाले की बँक चार्जेस अदर बँकिंग चार्जेस लाईक स्टेटमेंट बँकिंग स्टेटमेंट चार्जेस ऑल नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस आले आहे, देन शेअर इश्यू एक्सपेन्सेस डिबेंचर इश्यू एक्सपेन्सेस अँड अदर फिनान्शियल एक्सपेन्सेस इज डन। ओके त्याच्यानंतर जो व्हायचा तो ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट म्हणजे एवढा प्रॉफिट कसं बनत आहे, देन सम नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेन्सेस डन ऑन टाइम ऑफ फिनान्शियल इयर। आता विच वन असणार आहे, मे बी your sale of assets, assets vika kiwa nahi vika, if you sell assets or not, the production has stopped there, no production are working there, means production is depending on machinery and raw material, assets matlab mm-hmm. machinery serve nahi zale, production is working by labor and raw material, ya dogan mile honar aahe tar tyaje madhe asset asset kiwa nasat ani kay farak padnar nahi, then operating expenses direct jaya, then non operating income similarly the asset vika nahi ga beginning of benefit and non-operating income and other dividend receiver hai, dividend we are getting a per year we know kadhi tari bhetta mag kadhi tari bhetnar hai non-operating, so operating per year operate hot nahi hai, per year tax bhi dena nahi, salary we getting per year salary tumhara per year da lagte but your furniture per year ka na then non-operating expenditure. Okay from that non-operating income addition that NPBIDT means net profit before interest and depreciation are generated, what become net profit before interest tax and depreciation, it means you getting a net profit, here is a net profit right now but not properly because not properly because from this net profit interest on secure loan, interest on secure loan or secure loan part under the secure commodity so interest mainly the mortgage bank loan interest debenture interest je ka yena je balance sheet madhe apan shiklo ahe aani ya sathi balance sheet ghetle it is effect on your profit and loss is not effect on your balance sheet, in the profit and loss statement jo hai to tumhala net profit denar hai and it become a reserve and the reserve tumhala kothe effect denar hai on balance sheet madhe aani balance sheet ka performance directly samajle ka khup munanche ase loss hai ki income statement na jale income statement na this the total of depreciation deducted from here the answer become NPBIT, it become net profit before interest and tax, it known as net profit before interest and tax, here it becomes net profit is here it is a net profit hai, but interest and tax are being deducted as like interest it means interest it is secure loan for interest no other interest, it means here tumhara costing madhe aalo interest on debenture here interest on bank loan here but aalo interest on investment not here, karan ki investment is your investment business sathi interest dena aahe te tumhara bhetnar aahe income aahe not income aahe but they expendable as pay aahe. Okay then if interest are deducted from NPBIT the answers become NPBIT answer become NPBT. It's known as net profit before tax. It's known as net profit before tax. It means the profit before tax. Profit is already before tax. So the tax deduction, the tax reduction is remaining. Okay. Here under the list tax, which one tax are included? Corporate tax and final fixed tax means income tax. Means head of tax, the motor, direct tax are deducted. Mm-hmm. No indirect tax are deducted. Mm-hmm. And indirect tax, the postage, taxes, and telegrams are indirect means small expenditure. Then after that, NPAT means net profit after tax means your net profit are corrected. Okay. This is a proforma is explaining here. I'm explaining the proforma briefly here. After that, the sum component head are briefly explained together. The first is cost of goods sold. Under the cost of goods sold, COGS, training expenditure, and expenditure are included. For example, purchase of material, carriage, inward, carriage of factory, expenditure, and other. Then office and administration. Under this, all our office and training expenditure. Salary, stationery, manager expenses are included here. Then selling and distribution expenditure. Under this, all our time of sale expenditure, including the example of bad debt, advertisement, publicity charges, driving expenses, salesman salary are included here. Then finance expenses. Under this, including bank charges, share issue expenditure, and other. Then non-operating expenses. Which is non-operating expenses? The non-operating under this all of our operating expenditure will not affect towards your business is included. It means expenses, loss on sale of fixed asset or investment. Okay. And non-operating income under this all over non-operating income which is not affected towards your business are included. Example, profit on sale of fixed asset. Okay. Then depreciation under the all over depreciation maintenance. Then less interest under this, just CPR loan interest, direct rate from the interest from, for example, interest on debenture, interest on bank loan, interest on mortgage loan, etc. It means, karavacha interest, the loan fund madhe posting hona raha hai jachyavarti, loan fund madhe. Example, loan fund mein jo aane wala hai, uske andar. Then tax under the tax, it means overhead tax and income tax are posted here. Here your pro forma are completed. And briefly explain the kutla component you check that. That's it. Just two post format are here. You know that the some student from science and all. Then I'm explaining the trading account. What is trading account? The trading the opening stock purchase. Here the opening stock of raw material for production, purchase of raw material for production, less return. Return means the production return. Then wages. Time of production, labor kaam karta, the wages including here. Factory inwards, price and inwards charges, time of production are done there, which is including under this. Then carriage inward, factory rent, power, gross profit, sales return, closing stock, and other. They are the part of trading account. And this is from today the main thing under cost of goods sold. All over trading account performance is the samurai, which are the inner opening stock. Purchase, wages, freight, carriage, factory, power, etc. Fuel, then factory rent. J trading account madhe aadhi aayche the all over the posting under COGS, cost of goods sold. Okay. From that the credit side, are deducted from that. It means opening stock, add purchase, add credit charge. Server add on the less closing stock because closing stock showing in the credit of trading account. It could not like that trading sideline, but incredible other negative owner model after format from closing stock less of them. Then the second part profit and loss account. In this profit and loss account, can I calculate some sub parts are here mentioned here? Some sub parts are mentioned here, and three sub parts. First is and administration expenses. Second is selling and distribution expenses. Third is finance expenses. We are studying today how can we calculate. Okay? So, applicable to profit and loss account. Adi. So, how do you do that? Lump sum profit and loss account aside and to become net profit. आणि त्याच्यातून डेबिट साईड लेस केलं की आपण नेट प्रॉफिट डिरेक्ट करायचं. ऍज पर युअर फॉर्मॅट, टुडेज फॉर्मॅट, वन बाय वन आपण चेक करणार आहोत ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट और ग्रॉस मार्जिन सीयूजीएस लेस केल्यावर येणार आहे. सपोज इज ऑफिस अँड ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेन्सेस. ओके, द फर्स्ट इज ऑफिस अँड ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मध्ये बघा काय काय आहे. सॅलरी, रेंट, रेंट अँड टॅक्सेस, पोस्टेज अँड टेलिग्राम, टेलिफोन चार्जेस, प्रिंटिंग अँड स्टेशनरी, ऑफिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, इन्शुरन्स, लीगल चार्जेस. ओके, लीगल चार्जेस, लमसम सब चार्जेस बघा. सॅलरी ऑफिस स्टाफला दिले जाते, ऑफिशियल एक्सपेन्सेस. रेंट, रेंट अँड टॅक्स, त्याचं एक ऑफिस बांधलेलं असतं तिथे ते जमा होणार. ओके, टॅक्स टॅक्स ऑफिस, भाडं भरण्याची जागा, भाडं आणि असं रेट लावले जातात ते. पोस्टेज अँड टेलिग्राम बिल बनतो, ऑफिशियल बिल असतं ते भरतो. टेलिफोन चार्जेस टेलिफोन एक्सचेंज मध्ये भरले जातं. प्रिंटिंग अँड स्टेशनरी ऑफिशियल एक्सपेन्सेस. इन्शुरन्स इन्शुरन्स कंपनी मध्ये भरले जातं. ऑफिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बोर्डचं एक ऑफिस असतं तिथे ती केली जाते. देन ऑफिशियल एक्सपेन्सेस आर डन हियर. ओके, देन मार्केटिंग अँड सेलिंग एक्सपेंडिचर, दिस मीन युअर सेलिंग अँड डिस्ट्रीब्युशन एक्सपेन्सेस. हियर कॅरेज आउटवर्ड, फ्राइड आउटवर्ड, सेल्स सॅलरी, सेल्स सॅलरी इज मीन सेल्समॅन सॅलरी, ऍडव्हर्टाइजमेंट, गुड गोडाऊन रेंट, कमिशन रेंट, डिस्काउंट अलाउ अँड बॅड डेट्स आर मेंशन्ड हियर. ओके, देन फायनान्शियल अँड अदर एक्सपेन्सेस, फायनान्स एक्सपेन्सेस एज पर युअर. त्याच्यामध्ये बघा काय आहे, बँक चार्जेस, इंटरेस्ट, डेप्रिसिएशन ऑन युअर फायनान्शियल असेट्स, रिपेअर अँड मेंटेनन्स. ओके, देन डेप्रिसिएशन अंडर डेप्रिसिएशन, रिपेअर अँड मेंटेनन्स ऑल्सो इन्क्लुडिंग ऑफिस एक्सपेंडिचर, ऑडिट फी, फायनान्स चार्जेस. ओके, देन लॉस बाय थीफ, लॉस बाय थीफ ऑर ऍक्सिडेंट इज एक्सपेंडिचर इज अदर एक्सपेंडिचर. चोरी पुन्हा पुन्हा होत नाही, कधीतरी होणार आहे, अदर एक्सपेंडिचर. ऍक्सिडेंटल फायर अदर एक्सपेंडिचर, कधीतरी आग लागणार आहे, रोज आग लागणार नाही आहे. देन मिसलेनियस एक्सपेन्सेस अदर एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, ऑल्सो क्रेडिट साइड बघणार आहोत आपण. क्रेडिट साइड ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज युअर ग्रॉस मार्जिन, डायरेक्टली सीओजीएस लेस केलं. कमिशन रिसीव, कमिशन कधी भेटणार आहे, कधीतरी भेटणार आहे. जेव्हा जो वर्क डन अबाव देन युअर एक्सपेक्टेशन, इट मीन्स अदर नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इन्कम. रेंट रिसीव ऑपरेटिंग इन्कम, इंटरेस्ट रिसीव नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इन्कम, डिस्काउंट रिसीव नॉन ऑपरेटिंग. दिस आर सम इन्कम्स, आर इन्कम आर नॉट जनरेटिंग हियर. द ऑपरेटिंग इन्कम इज वन ऑनली सेल, बाय सेल जे इन्कम होणार आहे ती तुमची इन्कम आहे, अदर कधीतरी होणार आहे. दॅट्स वाय द ऑल ओव्हर मॅक्सिमम इन्कम्स आर इन्क्लुडेड अंडर नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इन्कम. ऑल ओव्हर येत नाही, ह्याच्यातून दोन तीन किंवा काहीतरी येणार आहे. ओके, वन मोर टाइम आय एम एक्सप्लेनिंग. एज पर युअर थ्री फॉर्मॅट मधले जर सब थ्री आहे, ऑफिस अँड ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेन्सेस, सेलिंग अँड डिस्ट्रीब्युशन एक्सपेन्सेस, फायनान्स एक्सपेन्सेस, हियर द थ्री पार्ट. ऑल्सो आय एम मेकिंग तुमच्या प्रॉफिट अँड लॉसला कसं येणार, त्यातलं काय येणार आहे ते सांगितलंय. फर्स्ट ऑफिस अँड ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेन्सेस, ह्याच्यामध्ये सॅलरी ऑफ ऑफिस पार्टनर्स, रेंट, रेंट अँड टॅक्सेस, पोस्टेज, टेलिग्राम, टेलिफोन चार्जेस, प्रिंटिंग स्टेशनरी, विच इज तुम्ही काय करायचं तर प्रॉफिट अँड लॉसच्या डेबिटला घ्यायचा. आता ते इन्कम स्टेटमेंटच्या ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंडिचरमध्ये येणार आहे आणि आउट ऑफ दॅट ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंडिचरमध्ये फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफिस अँड ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशनमध्ये ऑफिशियल एक्सपेन्सेस येणार आहे, विच इज इन्क्लुडिंग शोईंग हियर. ओके, देन मार्केट अँड सेलिंग, टाइम ऑफ सेलिंग जे होणार आहे ते इट इज सेलिंग अँड डिस्ट्रीब्युशन एक्सपेन्स. ह्याच्यामध्ये काय होणार आहे, ऑल टाइप ऑफ सेलिंग एक्सपेंडिचर, कॅरेज आउटवर्ड म्हणजे सामान विकण्यासाठी बाहेर घेऊन जाणे, फ्राइड आउटवर्ड फॉरेनला घेऊन जाणे फॉर सेल, देन सॅलरी, सेल्समॅन सॅलरी, कमिशन टू सेल्समॅन, देन डिस्काउंट अलाव अँड अदर एक्सपेंडिचर. देन फायनान्शियल एक्सपेन्सेस लाइक बँक चार्जेस, ऑडिट फी आर इन्क्लुडेड इन फायनान्स एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, देन
Thanks.